Fam.
Good afternoon. We're actually temporarily at my parents' house for this week until we can move into our new house officially, which we close on in like 2 days. Another vlog today. We're going to do another vlog style today, which is going to be little tidbits of everything we have going on, not just like one key point and then just ending it. So anyways, we're on our way to go get our adjustments at my dad's office real quick in the 7-3.
Such a pretty truck.
It is a long bed. You ready? Other than our adjustments, what should we do today? I kind of thought about going to look at that one first, Shin.
Go eat.
But I'm not sure. Eating? Yeah, that would be a good thing to do. We should probably do that at some point. But yeah, so Reagan and I are going to start doing some more vlog stuff, more than just like, here's a part, we're going to install it, and then we're done. You know what I'm saying? I think it's a good idea to give it a try. I think we should give it a try. So that's what we're gonna try doing here. Quick little announcement for the winner of the Loud and Proud Diesel Giveaway 12, Michael Nelson from, I think it's Norris City, Illinois. Congratulations, man. I've already spoken with him. He spoke with my attorney. Everything's good and squared away. We're all good. And he is going to be picking up the truck at the end of this week. Super stoked for you, man. Can't wait to meet you and sign over the truck to you. It's gonna be awesome. Anyways, guys, if you wanna win this 7-3 that we're sitting in right now, every $5 is 2 automatic entries to win, and the giveaway ends in 15 days. I don't know about you, but I think they should enter. We're on our way here now. We got to run by UPS as well to ship back our Wi-Fi box from our other house, because apparently they want the Wi-Fi box back. We're going to go get our adjustments and then possibly go look at it first gen. Not sure. We'll decide on that in a bit. Adjustments are done. We're on our way. We actually just looked at a first gen, and I'm so torn. Like, I see the potential in the truck. I know what we could do with it. It's just a matter of, do we want to put that much time and money into this truck? Because I know how much it's going to cost me, because I did all the numbers, and it's a little nerve-wracking thinking about how much work this truck would be, but I know in the end, because it's got a perfect frame, like it's so straight and so clean that I just know what the truck could look like, and that's what I'm hooked on. So I don't know. I'll let you guys know, but let me know, should we do a full first gen 5-speed 12 valve restoration or no? Yes or no, down in the comments.
Well, we just got back from the Dodge dealer. What do you think about the Durangos? Don't like them, like them?
It's really similar to like a Grand Cherokee, basically. That's what it felt like to me. Like, same, like, setup, like bucket seats.
Looks and feels just like my mom's Grand Cherokee on the inside, and that wasn't an RT.
That wasn't in the SRT version. That was in the RT version. The SRT was on the showroom floor, and we're like, oh, we'll just drive an RT just to get a feel for the way it steers and stuff, and you know, blind spots and stuff like that, to know if she even likes it before we pull their, you know, brand new SRT out of the showroom floor, numbered car, and throw it in the rain and salt. I mean, it felt good. It just, obviously, that model of the car just felt more like a Grand Cherokee than it did an SRT Durango. But you know, and we're driving kind of like driving past our new house right here, but we're on our way to go to the next lot, and we're going to be looking at some Cadillacs. Isn't that right?
Yep.
Cadillac. Now, not a brand new Cadillac, otherwise we would have went to a local lot, but it's a pre-owned 2018 Cadillac Escalade ESV. We're looking for a very specific interior, and that is brown saddle leather style, and they're kind of hard to find. She's got a certain taste, and I like that taste as well, but it's kind of a hard one to find in that particular vehicle. I do love the SRT Durango and the way it looks, and I'm sure it drives amazing, but it's gonna be hard to talk me out of that Escalade we just hopped in. I mean, how cool was that?
Cool.
It was cool. I mean, it just silky smooth, so plush. The seats were like just amazing. Power was really good. It's got that 6.2 liter V8 under the hood. I think it's like over 450 horsepower. The thing moves that 6,000 pound vehicle like that. I mean, it's really, really, it's something else. And it doesn't drive like a truck. I know it's on technically like a truck frame. Like, it's basically a GMC Denali 1500 with a Cadillac body on it, but it doesn't drive like a truck. It drives like a car, but it's the size of the truck, if that makes sense. So versus like the 7-3 here, it's a truck that drives like a truck because it's an old truck. I don't know how to explain it to make sense, That's the best I can do. But so we're on our way back home right now. But anyways, guys, that was nice. You're definitely gonna see more of that car, I'm sure. I mean, we're not decided, but that thing's pretty awesome.
Oh boy, so a couple things I wanna talk to you guys about. First one being her truck. Well, actually, I'll take that back. First one's gonna be the 7.3.
So of course, guys, the 7.3 is here and it is done. And every $5 that you spend on lmpgear.com gets you 2 automatic entries towards winning that truck. And you're down to the last 15 days, the last 2 weeks to enter to win that truck, plus $5,000 cash. Mind you.
So here's my other big question. It doesn't have anything to do with this truck, but just check out this truck and this lighting. You can see the brow. You can see the 15% tint. It looks so good. It looks really good. My question was this truck. So
today, of course, my wife and I looked at some Cadillacs. We looked at some Dodge Durangos. I want to ask you guys a couple questions. First question is Dodge Durango SRT or Cadillac Escalade ESV with the Platinum package in like brown leather interior and everything else. It's mint, it's awesome. When I drove that, it has that 6.2 liter, lots of horsepower, plenty for that vehicle, moves really good. It's good for towing if we need to haul horses, a trailer, or whatever, just in case we don't have a truck. That's gonna be my next question. What do you guys think? Comment down below what you guys think we should do on that, and we'll take it into consideration.
My next question is gonna be this truck. So my wife and I bought this truck just in August of this past year. I bought it for my wife as a birthday gift. I don't know if we're gonna keep it or not, and this is why I'm asking you guys. So my question would be, do you guys think I should keep this truck, build it for me as a personal truck, and with the blue truck either sell it or B, build it a little bit different for a giveaway at some point, and then keep this one for me as a newer daily driver? Or we already always have a giveaway truck that's done, like the Ford or the Longhorn back there, that hasn't been picked up quite yet, that I can always drive in the meantime. I don't really do much driving. If we do any long distance driving, we always drive my wife's vehicle. And if we bought her an Escalade or a Durango, again, if it's anything long distance, other than like just running into town a mile or two, we always just drive our personal vehicle, just so you guys know. So don't think like, oh, I'll just rack up a bunch of miles in your truck. No, that's not what I meant. My point is, if I absolutely need to take a vehicle and hers isn't available, worst case scenario, there's always a truck I can hop in. Or do I keep this truck as well and daily drive it, but then give it away like in a handful of months and do some cool stuff like custom interior that's different than any of the other trucks, American Force wheel setup on it, do some color matching, you know, do a little bit of a suspension change up. I mean, would you guys like to see something like that or no? Maybe you guys don't want to see it. Maybe you guys would just rather see the truck disappear. Maybe you want to see me turn it into a personable vehicle for myself. I don't know. Just let me know down in the comment section below, guys, and I will take everything into consideration.
Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, smash that thumbs up down below there. Subscribe if you're new. Join the team, join the family, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace.